Hello everybody, today we will see the last point of this thermometry and in which the Seebeck effect, what exactly meaning is to be there, that we will see in detail. So first of all, when the two things are to be very important as far as this first diagram is going to be concerned, here in this diagram, if you look at this, is what the case where the copper Cu is going to be having one galvanometer here, and it is to be here like this, and this one is to be galvanometer is attached, and another part that is to be this copper is going to be attached with the bismuth, is the another material. The two materials are to be there, and in which when one point is going to be heated, another point is becoming to be keeping as a cold, then in that stage there will be a current flow in this galvanometer, we will see. And this is somehow the first case where to be we will find the current conduction in such a way, either it is to be there for the two materials are to be there. And the effect first that is to be related with the Seebeck in 1821, it was to be discovered, and when the two junctions dissimilar materials in this previous diagram we have seen that the copper and that is to be as an bismuth is going to be used. And here the two junctions are there, with the two junctions with the dissimilar materials are to be there, and when one junction is heated and other junction is kept cold, and in that case the current flows through the circuit without any battery, and that is the case where this galvanometer shows flow of current in this case. The important factor about this case is to be one junction was heated and the other was cold, the current flows through the galvanometer. The same effect was to be observed using this FeM ion, that is to be when the it is to be connected instead of this copper, and the iron is going to be used, and both the junctions when kept at the 0 degree centigrade, and then that stage there will be no current flows through there, and this is somehow the we are looking for now copper, and the instead of bismuth there is iron, and when both are kept at 0 degree, then there will be no current flow, that current will not flow through the circuit, and when both the junctions are maintained at a different temperature, current flows from the copper to the iron, that is Cu to Fe, and at hot junction is to be there, means the at one junction if suppose it is heated and other another junction is kept at cold, in that case the current flow will be from copper to iron. If you look at this diagram, this is what the second one diagram, here if you look at this case where it is to be as in first one case where we have seen when there is a two junctions are to be there, the if you look at this first diagram carefully, I will show you here. Look at this case where this one is the first case what we are discussing, that this is what the copper which is connected with the galvanometer, and the another is to be bismuth. Here are these two junctions, bismuth with the copper. This bismuth is connected with the copper, and here is another junction, bismuth is connected with the copper. Now in this case, If suppose one junction, this is called to be suppose one end and this is first junction, and suppose this is to be as a second junction, and in this case one junction is heated and another junction is kept at cold. In this case there will be a current conduction, and that will be shown by the galvanometer. Now instead of this bismuth, if suppose I am changing this bismuth with the Fe, and here is the another diagram which is showing you the changes what is going to be occurring. So look at this second diagram. The copper is here, same Cu, which is connected through the galvanometer is to be there, but the bismuth is replaced with iron, that is Fe, and the same condition is to be kept in this case. There are two junctions. This one is supposed to be first junction, and this one is supposed to be, this one is to be as a second junction, where it is to be iron and the copper is going to be there. Iron and copper is to be there. These are the two junctions. This one is the first junction, this one is the second junction. Now in this case, if suppose when both are at 0 degree, when there is no cold, there is no hot is to be there, both the junctions 1 and 2 is kept at 0 degree centigrade, then there will be no current conduction through the circuit. But when there is a difference, means first junction is heated through this burner and second junction is kept at cold, that is in the ice bath, so in this case the current conduction will be from copper to iron when there is a difference in the heat, that is the difference in the temperature is to be there. One junction is hot, another junction is at cold. In such a condition the current flow will be from copper to iron, and that will be shown in this galvanometer. So this is what the first case. Now suppose the temperature is going on and increasing and increasing. If the cold if this temperature of the hot junction is kept at 270 degree, if the temperature is of hot junction is increased beyond 270, the current gradually decreases. That means up to 0 to 270, when the temperature is going on increasing from 0 to 270, the current flow will be from copper to iron. That is Fe to copper at cold junction. At hot junction it is from copper to iron. Let's see the case. At hot junction, this is what the hot junction, this is what the hot junction. At this stage, from 0, when the temperature is increased from 0 to 270, there will be a current flow, and that current flow for the hot junction, this is what the hot junction, the current flow will be in this direction from copper to iron, Fe. But at the same time, for the cold junction, this current flow will be from Fe to copper. That means iron to copper will be there for cold part, that is to be there. When it will happen? It will happen only from 0 to 270 degree centigrade. म्हणजे 0 to 270 degree temperature पर्यंत gradually ह्याच्यामध्ये काय होणार, temperature will goes on increasing, and at hot junction the current flow will be from copper to iron, and at cold junction the current flow will be from iron to copper. This will happen only for 0 to 270 degree. and the current will goes on increasing gradually when the temperature is going on increasing from 0 to 270. But beyond the 270 degree temperature, the current flow goes on decreasing. म्हणजे 270 डिग्री टेम्परेचर जेव्हा जाईल किंवा त्याच्या पुढे जेव्हा टेम्परेचर जाईल त्यावेळेस ह्याच्यामध्ये जो इन्क्रीज होत होता टेम्परे करंटमध्ये तो करंटमधला इन्क्रीज स्लो होऊन जाईल आणि हळूहळू डिक्रीज व्हायला लागेल बियॉन्ड 270 डिग्री. अप टू 270 डिग्री करंट फ्लोमध्ये ग्रॅज्युअल इन्क्रीज दाखवणार, पण 270 नंतर त्याच्यामध्ये डिक्रीज व्हायला लागेल हळूहळू. And that is what for the both the junctions it will happen. And this is what when this goes on increasing and increasing up to 540. म्हणजे जर समजा हेच जर टेम्परेचर मी इन्क्रीज करत गेलो 270 पासून ते 540 पर्यंत, तर हे हळूहळू डिक्रीज होत जाऊन करंट अप टू कुठपर्यंत जाणार, इट विल बिकम झिरो. म्हणजे 270 ते 540 डिग्री टेम्परेचरपर्यंत जेव्हा टेम्परेचर इन्क्रीज करत जाऊ तर हळूहळू हळूहळू त्या टेम्परे त्या करंट फ्लोमध्ये डिक्रीज होत जाऊन जाऊन शेवटीला 540 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेडला दोन्ही जंक्शनमधला जे करंट फ्लो आहे तो बिकम झिरो. अँड वॉट विल हॅपन बियॉन्ड दी 540 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड मीन्स याच्याही पुढे when if the temperature is increased beyond this 540 degree centigrade, the whatever be the hot junction is increased in the direction of the current is going to be reverse. Manje 540 degree temperature peksha jeva temperature jast vadel tya veles hot junction cha je kai direction hota. हॉट जंक्शनच्या जवळ कसं डायरेक्शन होतं, सी यू पासून म्हणजे कॉपरपासून आयर्नला जे काही करंट फ्लो ह्या डायरेक्शनने करंट फ्लो होत होता, तर तो करंट फ्लो काय होईल 540 झिरो होऊन जाईल आणि 540 बियॉन्ड टेम्परेचरला काय होत जाणार, हे डायरेक्शन चेंज होणार. म्हणजे एफ ई म्हणजे आयर्न टू कॉपर हे कोणत्या जंक्शनजवळ, हॉट जंक्शनजवळ होणार. इन दी सेम वे at the cold junction it will also goes on decreasing in the reverse direction. At cold junction jevul kay hot hota adi up to 540 fe to cu ya direction ni current flow hot hota, pan beyond 540 the direction will goes in the reverse direction, that is cu to fe at cold junction, second junction is to be there. So this is what the case beyond the 540 degree centigrade, the direction of the current goes to be reverse and cell is called to be as a thermoelectric current is to be there, and there is no battery at all inside it, and the EMF generated is called as a Seebeck effect. He asha prakarani je kai reverse direction madhe current flow hotoy asha prakarcha jo effect ahe that will called as a Seebeck effect is to be there. So this is what the case where the particularly what happens at these two junctions are to be there. The temperature of the hot junction at which maximum current flows through the circuit is called the neutral temperature, and that is the hot junction at which maximum current flows. Manje at hot junction la jase ki ya diagram madhe jar samjun baktal the temperature versus current flow jo ka ahe ha itha graph dakulela ahe. सुरुवातीला फ्रॉम इफ यू लुक ॲट दिस केस केअरफुली दिस डायग्राम शोज व्हॉट हॅपन्स एक्झॅक्टली फॉर दी हॉट जंक्शन इज गोईंग टू बी कन्सर्न. ग्रॅज्युअली द करंट फ्लो करंट ॲट द बोथ द जंक्शन करंट फ्लो इज करंट इज गोईंग टू बी इन्क्रीझिंग ॲज द टेम्परेचर इज गोईंग टू बी इन्क्रीझिंग, बट दिस विल हॅपन ओनली अप टू 270. म्हणजे 270 डिग्री टेम्परेचरपर्यंत काय होणार आहे, दोन्ही जंक्शनमध्ये current will goes on increasing and increasing as the temperature goes on increasing and increasing up to 270. At the hot junction the current will flow from the copper to iron, and at the cold junction the current will flow from the iron to copper in this direction. and gradually there will be increase, but this increase will be only up to 0 to 270 degree temperature. The current will goes on increasing only up to 270 degree temperature. As beyond this 270 degree temperature, the current flow goes on decreasing and decreasing and up to zero. Manje, beyond 270 degree temperature, the current flow at the hot junction from the copper to iron, and at the cold junction from iron to copper, will goes on decreasing when the temperature will be beyond 270, and this will gradually goes on decreasing and decreasing and decreasing, and it will become zero at 540 degree. And this is what the 540 degree it will completely becomes to be zero. And beyond that 540 degree temperature, the direction of the current is going to be reverse. आणि बियॉन्ड 540 डिग्री टेम्परेचरच्या पुढे काय होणार आहे, द करंट डायरेक्शन ॲट द हॉट जंक्शन इट विल बी फ्रॉम Fe टू कॉपर नाव ॲट बियॉन्ड दॅट 540 डिग्री टेम्परेचर, अँड ॲट द कोल्ड जंक्शन इट विल बी फ्रॉम कॉपर टू आयर्न. सो द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द करंट विल बी रिवर्स वेन द टेम्परेचर विल बी बियॉन्ड 540 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. And this is what called as a Seebeck effect, and that is here the diagram shows here to be as an for the hot junction is to be there, and here is the current flow is shown for this case. And when the current flows at the hot junction is going to be increasing, maximum current flows through the circuit, it is called to be as a natural temperature. And for given thermocouple, the neutral temperature is to be fixed irrespective of the temperature of the cold junction. The graph is showing to be here as the thermo EMF versus the temperature of a hot junction with the cold junction maintained at 0 degree. It is shown in this figure is to be there. And this thermo EMF varies with the temperature according to the relation, that is E is equal to AT plus PT square is to be there. And A and B are the constants, and if the A represents the neutral temperature and the B represents the inversion temperature where the current is reverse. This is what the case where the figure 1 and 2 is going to be showing. And first figure was to be related with the case for both the cases we are using the same diagram. And we are not shown here to be as in second diagram is to be there. Current flow directions are not shown, but the same diagram is to be there with the direction change is to be there. And if theta 1 is the temperature of the cold junction and theta 2 is nothing but to be temperature of inversion is to be there. So in this case, if I want to explain related with the part as neutral temperature is nothing but to be given in this fashion, that is theta n minus theta 1 is equal to theta 2 minus theta n is to be there. And here is the case where the both the changes inversion and the theta 2 is nothing but to be temperature of inversion, and that is to be there where the direction of the current are going to be changing, that is called the temperature of inversion beyond 540. And theta n is the neutral temperature, and theta 1 is the temperature of the cold junction. And if I want to show this relationship, theta n minus theta 1, that is the at the theta n is to be as a neutral temperature minus the theta 1 is the temperature of the cold, is equal to theta 2 temperature of inversion minus the theta n, that is the natural neutral temperature is to be there. So in this case, if I calculate this theta n, it is nothing but to be given with the theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 is to be there. So if you look at this case where to be as an simply when at the both the sides to be as an theta n, jar samja mi ikade ghetla tar ha plus hon jail, manje theta n plus theta n, that is 2 theta n hoil, and is equal to ha theta 1 jar ikade ghetla तर हा प्लस होऊन जाईल, म्हणजे थीटा 1 प्लस थीटा 2 होऊन जाईल. आणि हा 2 जर ह्याला डिवाइड केला तर थीटा एन इज इक्वल टू मला लिहिता येते theta n is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 by 2 is to be here. So in this case I can calculate the neutral temperature of any thermocouple is to be there, that is copper, iron, or the any type of the two junctions are to be there. And if the temperature of the cold is to be 100, the temperature of inversion will be 444 degree centigrade. And this is what the case for the copper, manje for the copper and the iron thermocouple, the cold junction is, if suppose at 100 degree centigrade, at the same time the temperature of inversion will be 444 degree centigrade. So this is what the case where the we can calculate the neutral temperature. So the case was to be very simple, and how the Seebeck effect is to be there. The Seebeck effect can be explained on the basis of the free electron theory of metals also. The metals are composed of the free electrons. The electrons are free to move anywhere within the boundaries of the metal, like the atoms, as we have to know that the metal is to be a good conductor, and whenever the any external temperature, any external field is to be given, the electron will be transferred easily from that metal. And that's why these metals are called to be as an containing as a free electrons inside it. And these electrons will works as a free molecules of any gas. And the number of electrons in this metal, different metal is different. When the two different metals are joined together, there is a tendency of electron to diffuse across the junction when the two metals are going to be attached. The flow of the current continues until the contact potential difference across the junction is high enough to prevent movement of the electron. If the junctions are at the same temperature, the contact potential is the same and both the junctions, and at that time there will be no transfer of electron. If the junctions are maintained at different temperature, the contact potential differences at the two junctions and are not equal, and the current flows from one junction to the another junction. So this is what explained this Seebeck effect in the another way. जर समजा दोन मेटल घेतले आपण, डिफरंट मटेरियल, आणि त्याच्यामधले जे काही इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आहेत ते बोथ आर कॉल टू बी एज अन गुड कंडक्टर्स ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, सॉरी गुड कंडक्टर्स वी कॅन से, अँड इलेक्ट्रॉन फ्लो इझिली इन द बोथ वेज. सो इफ यू हॅव जॉईंड दॅट बोथ द इलेक्ट्रॉन, बोथ द मेटल्स आर टू बी देअर, अँड इन दॅट केस वॉट एवर द फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, वेन द पोटेन्शियल डिफरन्सेस आर इक्वल, देर विल बी नो ट्रान्सफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल बी देअर. But as the temperature variation is to be there, means one metal is going to be hot and another metal is to be supposed to be cold, in that differences in the potential differences, that will be the current flow will be there in this case, and particularly Seebeck effect will be observed in that case also. So this is what the Seebeck effect in the metals, different metals at the different junctions, what is the current flow will be there, that we have explained with the experimental setup and by the Seebeck, and that's why this Seebeck effect having the importance. As far as the copper and the iron, the neutral temperature will be 100 degree centigrade, at the same time inversion of the temperature will be 444 degree centigrade. So this is for the Seebeck effect and all the details related with the Seebeck effect. Thank you for the joining this session, and be at home and be safe. Thank you.